viewers, this is Mystic C from Magic Wands Tarot, and this is a pick a card reading for Will He Come Back to You or Will He Return to You, and a song for you. So this reading was requested heavily on here on YouTube and also on my Instagram page, Magic Wands Tarot, friends. So here it is now, all your requested readings are coming, yay! So before we begin, angels, please subscribe. Thank you so much if you have already subscribed. Thank you so much. Don't forget to click the bell icon so that you never miss a reading when it is posted. And also, friends, these are general readings. They may resonate with you or they may not. So take whatever resonates with you and leave the rest behind. Also, friends, these are timeless readings. Whenever you come across them, they will help you out in some way. And also, friends, do join us on Instagram and Facebook as Magic Wands Tarot. There's a lot happening there every day. And if you want to buy a personal reading like this, or a twin flame reading, or yearly 2020 readings, they are also on. Full readings are on discounts and sale now. So yeah, you can check them out and beat the last minute rush. Check the description box or visit our website to book a reading. And let's take a deep breath now. Relax. Take a deep breath, choose Phal 1, this beautiful pink heart, Phal 2, the beautiful green heart, Phal 3, this beautiful blue heart, Phal 1, Phal 2, Phal 3. I will leave the timestamps in the comment section below, friends, so you can directly skip to the number that you have chosen. If not, you can watch the entire video, friends, and you can also choose more than one pile if you feel drawn towards that. So for those who chose option number one, this beautiful pink heart, will your person come back to you, and what is the song for you? Let's see that. So we'll check these later on. Alrighty, beautiful, beautiful cards. I feel your person could be an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person, or you are an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini person. I feel this person is definitely feeling that you are the empress of their life, you are the queen of their life. If you are a woman, if you please just interchange it. If you are a man and you are asking about a woman, these are general readings, so you can please change the gender as according to your situation. But I feel this person is really seeing you in your power, in your energy, in your total what you say, glory. This person definitely is coming to a new sense of awakening. This for your person is feeling very, very connected to you. They are feeling that you are the queen of their life, the king of their life. They feel that you are the most nurturing person, the most beautiful person they have ever known. They feel that you are the empress, you know. Empress is someone like she's the you know, she's the sum of all the queens. She's above all the queens, and she has all the qualities of all the queens. The queen of earth, the queen of pentacles, the queen of cups, the queen of wands, the queen of swords. All of them together makes the empress, and they see that you are like the mixture of everything and the goddess and the god energy. It's beautiful. This person wants to talk to you. This person definitely feels that they want to communicate, they want to work things out with you, I feel. And I feel that you have also shifted. They might you have also shifted your energy from being a little cold towards them or turning your back towards them. You have also become a bit receptive towards them. That's why you are watching this video, I would say, or this reading. And this person may have also been a bit harsh to you in the past. They may have been a bit cold, and they are also trying to step out of that energy. They may have been a bit selfish to you in the past, I feel. And a bit rude also, I don't know why. But yeah, this energy they were in, this energy they were in, it's now changing for sure. And they are trying to really be assertive and make a move towards you. They are trying to become better for you, and they are working on themselves. That is what I feel. And I feel they try to run away from you. But it is like you have such a magnetic aura, a magnetic personality. You are the queen of queens, you know, the king of kings. And you can see this person wants to run away, but then they keep thinking about you. Can you see? This person keeps looking back at you. It's like, no matter where they go, you are constantly on their mind. There is this invisible pull between you both, and it keeps, pulling them back and pulling them back. And it is your energy, actually. It is your beautiful energy that keeps pulling this person back. And yes, this person is surely trying to work on something. They may have appeared to be in their own energy of coldness in the past. They may have hurted you, or they may have been a bit rude also. They might have also been more focused on themselves, but I feel that's changing and they are gaining their courage back to come back to you. They are trying to be assertive to make that move towards you. They are trying to break down anything that's standing in their way, and they have discovered something very, very vital recently. That is what I feel when I say that, sorry, friends, they may see you as the Empress now. They were not earlier, they were not able to see this because their own energy or their own mind was clouded, but now something has shifted and this person is coming to a realization. They have discovered something and they have awakened to your power and what this connection actually is. And this might have happened when you were not in touch with them. You might have separated. This separation, this cold war between you both may have happened, and this cold war may have led to an awakening, to a discovery within them that yes, you are the queen of queens, you are the queen of their heart, and yes, you are the one they are looking for, and they have discovered something, and definitely they want to mend this relationship. They are working to mend their own ways, soften their own energy. I feel this person has been a little egoistic in the past also, because if they are an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person, they, sorry to say that, I'm not trying to be rude to anybody. It's just that sometimes what I'm getting, I'm telling you that from the cards, that this person could have come out as egoistic, but now you have taught them to like step back into your own power. Like you have taught them where you belong or what is their place, and that really pushed them into a sense of self-discovery. And yeah, this person definitely wants to work things with you. They want to come back to you, and definitely you are on their mind. They are trying to work out something. I feel this person constantly looks at the past and is trying to figure out what really went wrong so that they can actually fix it this time when they are back again to you, with you. What else is coming? And I feel this is a very cyclic relationship because the moon is here. This person feels a lot of emotions for you. You may feel a lot of emotions for them, but somehow you both are not in touch right now, or not in contact, so nobody is talking. There is a cold war going in, but they are trying to really come back and mend this thing and share their emotions with you. Let us see what is the extra message in the song for you. Let us restart from where we left. I told you this person keeps going back to those old times which you had both shared. He or she keeps going back. And see here also, this person hasn't gotten over you and they want to come back to you. They want to start things from scratch, or they want to start things from where you both had left it. They want to end this cold war with you and make passionate love with you and contact with you, talk with you all night. Whatever you had in the beginning, they want that now. And this person could be your friend's friend, or this person wants friendship. Or this person, you might have common friends, so they keep asking them what you are doing or something like that. This person surely wants a friendship with you so that they can work things out and make it a love partnership again. That is what I feel. Because I feel this person feels that somehow things got lost or muddy or confusing or hurtful because of the intense love connection you both share. If you both have focused a bit more on friendship, things would have worked out. So this person wants to come in and start as a friendship or as a friendly way so that they can, since you are in this Empress energy, they don't want to mess with you in any way. Yeah, definitely. So let's see what is the song from them for you. Oh my goodness gracious. I love when this happens. So I use the Song Shuffler app for shuffling the songs, and randomly one song came out for your pile, and I have written the lyrics down for that, and you're gonna laugh. The song is Queen of My Heart by Westlife, and look at this. Queen of Queens. Amazing. This person is surely in love with you, darling, and they're gonna come back really quickly. Look, let's see. The song is Queen of My Heart by Westlife, and the lyrics are: So here we stand in a secret place where the sound of crowd is far away. You took my hand, it feels like home. We both understand where we belong. We both have our dreams, we both want to fly. So let us take a moment to carry us through this lovely time. When I found my way back to you, Queen of my heart, you are the queen of my heart. Wow, beautiful. So you see, you both are very similar ambition people. We both have our dreams, we both want to fly. So let us take a moment to carry us through the lovely times. When I find my way back to you, Queen of my heart, you are the queen of my heart. Well, go check this out, this song, Queen of My Heart by Westlife. You may enjoy this song, and it may mean something to you important. This person surely wanna come back to you. They are thinking about you, and you are on their mind, and definitely they see you as the queen of queens or the king of kings, the empress energy. That's it for you, pile number one. Please do subscribe if you enjoyed this reading. And if you wanna buy a personal reading, check the description box, friends, and do let me know in the comment section below if you enjoyed this reading. For those who chose the option number two, this beautiful greeny, greeny, sparkly green heart. Will this person come back to you? And what is the song for you? Let's see that. Alrighty, lots of cards came out for you actually. So I feel the person you're asking about could be an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person. Definitely, I feel fire and air energy very, very strongly here. I feel that. Okay. Oh my God. I feel this person is going through a lot in their at the moment in their life. I feel this person is feeling weighed down by responsibilities, duties, careers. I feel this person is very wise and they are very mature. There could be an age difference between you and them. Or like they are younger and you are maturer. There is that energy of young and mature that's coming in here. But I feel this person is currently going through a very, very hard time in their life. They are really struggling with a lot of challenges in their life for sure. And I also feel this could be guilt for some of them. This could be like they are weighed down by guilt for something they did to you or something that happened in the past. I feel this person has a lot of grief for what happened in the connection with you or something, or they may just personally have a lot of grief. Due to how hard life is for them, I feel this person is really having a lot of challenges in their life. And a lot of things like suddenly their job is taken, or like they are experiencing a lot of trouble at their job. That is what I feel. They have a lot of family issues also going on. Like a lot of family conflicts or pressures are on them. And this person definitely feels like they need to end something so that they can begin something new. But they are really struggling and really feeling downtrodden and really load, you know, they are feeling the load of the life right now. And if you haven't heard from them, it is because of this, because they are dealing with a lot of challenges in their life. It could be work related, it could be family related, it could be like their job, they are jobless currently, or they had been, you know, they are looking for a new job or something like that, or there has been a lot of guilt or shame for something they did to you or what happened in the past or way things happened in your relationship. That's what is also coming here. I feel this person is definitely heading towards a new start, a new beginning, a new hope coming into their life. This dark energy, this dark place, this period of struggle in their life is going to shift, and they are going to come to a new sense of awakening, a new sense of goodness and happy things happening in their life. And I feel until they are in this energy of load and struggle, it might be difficult for them to contact you or come back to you or get in touch with you, but they are dreaming about this new beginning with you, this passionate new start with you. They really feel like, wow, how wonderful it would be if you both were together and working and, you know, had this new amazing new start and passionate new beginnings. They are dreaming about it, and I think that is what is giving them hope from this struggles and all these hard times they are going right now. They definitely are focusing on themselves. They are trying to work, they are trying to expand their life, they are also trying to heal. They might be trying to, you know, this person is waiting, assessing, they are planning their next steps, they are focusing on themselves, they are trying to you know, assess how to get back to you, because currently they are at a very difficult place right now. So they are really trying to work things out, work out on themselves, you know, work their career, their family, and all those tensions they are trying to balance out. And I feel definitely this person has some grief that they are struggling with. Either, you know, you both may have some karmic stories attached that's causing trouble between you both, but they feel like they caused you grief or something, or they hurted you a lot, and that is weighing on their heart, because I feel a very heavy heart here. And either this person is married, or you were married and there was like or there was this issue about marriage, like marriage didn't happen or didn't go the way as it wanted, or you both wanted. There is some sort of a heavy grief this person is going through, and I feel it is because they feel they have hurted you in some way. They might have, I don't know why I'm also getting children issues here. Maybe they haven't children, or you have children, or you both had a past life where you both had children together, and that's causing some grief or some sort of a situation in your life. I don't know, it's these are general readings, take whatever resonates with you please. But I feel they did something to you which has caused you grief, and that's why they feel very, very heavy hearted, and they are trying to release that for sure. They are trying to release some old stories, some old baggage they are carrying. They are trying to negate and balance the weight they are feeling on their shoulders. They might be also very tired about the past stories, or there might be some past issues that are affecting their life currently. There may be an ex-wife or a ex-partner that's causing them problem, and that is why they cannot come to you right now. So there is something happening that they are releasing, and they have already released, or they are releasing, and they are trying to work on it. And definitely they are hoping for a new start with you sometime soon. And yeah, no place like home. They feel that you are the home for them. You are the most beautiful person to them. You are the home, the safe place, the heaven, safe heaven they come back to. And even in these dark times, you are like a guiding. You can see this lighthouse. This house is lighted and it's right above the clouds, like guiding everything around it. So yeah, they see you as a mentor, as a guide, as a spiritual light in their life. You are the home to them, and definitely higher powers are keeping your relationship safe and protected from anything that's happening now. And I feel higher powers are acting, your destiny, or destiny you can say, is acting for you both. And if this person is not in contact with you right now, you may have to wait a while, because there is a lot going on in their life. But don't worry, it is a divine plan. When the right time appears or comes, this person is gonna come back to you, and there might be a passionate new start for you both. So don't worry about it. Just let's send this person a lot of blessings. Let us see what is the message. Recluse, nobody knows what I feel. Oh, good Lord. Oh, sorry, friends. I told you this person has a lot of heavy energies. They might have not told you that they love you. They might not be telling you that how much guilty they feel or ashamed they are of something. I don't know what is it. And I feel that this person is a very high recluse, and even now this hard time they are going through, they are not sharing it with anybody. And you might be wondering, like, they might be happy and all, but they know they are going through something and they are not talking about it, not even with you or to anybody around them. So yeah, keep that in mind. Recluse, nobody knows what I feel, and I feel they feel that you are the home for them, and that's what they are not telling you, and they want this new beginning with you. They are looking for a new time to take action, to be fearless and happily pursue your most treasured dreams and amazing love and career opportunities. See, let us see what is the song from this person, because this person is a recluse. The song is a very important message from them to you. Oh goodness gracious, I don't know, you should check this song out. It is a really apt song for and correct song for this situation. The song is by Alan Walker. It is called Alone. Alan Walker, Alone. Lost in your mind, I wanna know, I am. Am I losing my mind? Never let me go. If this night is not forever, at least we are together. I know I'm not alone. I know I'm not alone. Anywhere, whenever. Apart but still together. I know I'm not alone. Unconscious mind, I'm wide awake. Wanna feel one time. Take my pain away. Oh, good Lord. Darlings, let's take a moment and send this person a lot of love, whoever this is, or whoever souls, or you know, all of these people are. Let's send them some love. And I feel this person is really going through a tough time, and that is why you are not in touch or not heard from this person. And definitely you are guiding them, and you wanna go and hear this song Alone by Alan Walker. Lost in your mind, I wanna know, am I losing my mind? Never let me go. This person has a lot of pain and they just don't want you to let go of this connection. It may take a while before you hear from them, that's for sure, because until this thing is healed, I think destiny is working with you both, so you have nothing to worry about. Just see how it goes. That's what I have the advice for you. That's it. Subscribe, friends. Subscribe if you enjoyed this reading, and do let me know in the comment section below if you enjoyed this reading, if it resonated. And if you want to buy a personal reading, check the description box, friends. Join us on Instagram and Facebook. I love these song readings. Don't you love them? Tell me in the comment section. Do you want more song readings? What readings you want? Let me know in the comment section, friends. For those who chose option number 3, the beautiful in electric blue indigo heart. So here's your person coming back and a song for you. Sorry, friends. My throat is not good. A lot of work here actually going on. Alrighty. So I feel that the person you have in mind could be a Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus person, or they are a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces person, or an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person. I feel this person you are asking about, this person sees you as someone who is very, very beautiful, who is very confident, who is very, very bold. They see you as someone who is very outgoing, very outspoken, very bold. You are fearless in some way. They see you like the sun that comes out every day and lightens everybody's life. You are not afraid to do what you like or enjoy in life. You are fearless in every way. It's like you are beautiful and they just cannot take their eyes off you. And they know that you are very, very powerful and you are this mighty sun, you know. You know when to rest, you know when to work, you are very fearless, you are very bold, you are creative, you are successful, you love a lot. I mean, they see you like the sun who has nothing wrong with it, you know, like the epitome of sun, the epitome of love. They see you that way. But I feel that this person in the past could have ghosted you in some way. For some of you, it might be very specific for some of you, or it could be for all of you, I'm not sure. But I feel this person has ghosted you in the past. Yeah, I definitely feel that. Or you walked away, or this person suddenly walked away. They gaslighted you or ghosted you, or you may have walked away, suddenly turned your back. But I feel since we asked about them, I feel this is their energy. They did something like that to you in the past. And I feel this person has this, they did this because they were in the energy of their ego, the pride, the senselessness, the mind, the rational mind. They were very much in their ego-hearted energy, egocentric energy, three-dimensional patterns. This person was not thinking straight. They were like, yeah, I can do whatever I like, or they might have acted on their fears or on their ego, and that would have caused the walk off. Either they walked away or you walked away, or you both walked out of this situation. But I feel like someone really put in the work in this situation. I feel you were really trying to put work, make this situation work a lot. Like you put in a lot of hard work to make this relationship work, and they surely notices that you did a lot, but they were like in their egoistic energy, they were in their pride. They were not doing anything, and that may have caused you a lot of anguish, a lot of pain. I feel this person is definitely had some confusions in the past, like they were not sure what to do about this beautiful relationship. They might have felt even insecure, or what is the word? What do you say that thing? They felt like they were not the right person for you in some way. Like you are the sun, you are beautiful, you are heart-centered, and they are this egoistic person. They may have been fear-based. They may have felt like they are not even a match to you compared to your energy, your beauty and love. They may have felt very confused about what to do in this situation, and that might have caused, and their ego might have told them, or some fears might have affected and led to this energy of ghosting or walking away, or you walked away from them. They were in some sort of a confusion. I feel this person has a twin energy, like they can be very, very double-minded person. They can be very moody or very insecure or very, very quick to move from one emotion to another, and that's flighty. This person could be flighty in some way, not because they want to be, just because it is their inherent nature or something like that. This person surely had some confusion when they met you, or in the past, or currently also they are going through some confusions, but I feel they are coming out of that confusion. They are really coming out of that confusion. They are trying to recover the things. They are trying to understand themselves. They are trying to understand the situation. They are trying to see what is the key in this relationship. What is the key problem? I think the key problem is their ego, their pride, their fears. But I think they have realized it, and they are trying to recover it. They are moving out of this confused energy they had in the past, and they are trying to recover out of it. And they are trying to enter into the energy of the lovers. They want to give you commitment. They want to promise you love. They want to offer you love, nourishment, and compatibility. And they want to be an equal to you. That's what I feel. Because in the past, they didn't felt equal. You are both very strong, but they are like the devil, and you are like the sun. It's like stark opposites of each other. How you cannot be more opposite than this. And also in the same way, you are similar, because you are both very strong. And devil is the opposite of lovers, you know. It is like, it's the same card in the traditional tarot. It's the same card, but it is the lovers are chained with a chains around a devil. So it's the same card. So they are trying to shift this energy into the energy of lovers. Amazing, very, very interesting, and very, very fascinating and powerful reading for sure. I mean, you can see how this person definitely, and this is the confusion they have. Like sometimes they are in this energy of lovers, other times they are in the energy of this ego, And that is their confusion. And you may have also faced it with them. It's like, wow. But I feel they are really recovering from the situation and they are trying to become more stable in the energy of lovers, commitment, balance, opening of their heart, giving you and becoming more balanced as a person within their energy and offering you a commitment and becoming your equal in some way. They are working on this for sure. Again, this card is here between the worlds. This person definitely is a very moody and a fluctuating person. They can be in and out of your life. And this person is trying to move out of the darkness into the light. From the devil energy into the lover's energy. But you can see they may still have that energy of fluctuations. Moving between two worlds or something like that. Or coming, going in and out of your life. You have to accept it. They are trying to balance themselves for sure. They want to come back to you because they definitely see you as the sun. They see you as a very, very strong person. They see you as a fearless, bold person. And you are like an inspiration to them. You are guiding them to stay in this lover's energy and not go back to be a devil. To the sea. I feel this person is taking some time off. That's why you haven't heard from them. They are like spending time alone in reflection, just focusing on their own energy and trying to understand why they keep fluctuating between these two energies of lovers and devil. They are really trying to understand this situation deeply, and this is because you have pushed them to actually see themselves. And yeah, I feel this person will come in back into your life, but because they are working on recovery, they are trying to heal the confusion, they are working hard, but I feel this person may again go back quickly if they are not properly healed. So you may have to be like, you may have to give them a few chances to know whether they have totally recovered from this confusion or they are still in the in-between energies. You have to... They may go in and out of your life. I'm sorry to say that, but that's how it is coming. I want to fix things. See, this person wants to fix things. If they ghosted you, they know, they understand, and they want to work things out with you. They see you as the sun. Can we be more than friends? I feel you might have been friend-zoned this person. For some of you, you may have like, no, you are too pride and too egoistic, I don't want to talk. Or you both might be taking a break from each other. But this person will come in, definitely always want to be more than a friend to you, that's for sure. But I feel they will be in and out of your life. It's just the way they are, or it's until they balance out things. Let's see what is the song for you, because I feel song is important here. Coming to You by Jill Scott. Coming to You by Jill Scott. I am on my way to show you. I am not gonna wait beside the road now. No, no. I know the world's been getting you, babe. It's such a heavy load. You got to hold on now. Don't let your hearts be confused no more. Don't be misled, as I'm almost there, baby. And when I get to you, babe, gonna leave all the old stuff on floor. I'm coming to you, babes. Oh my goodness gracious. I told you this song fits perfectly with their situation. This person wants you to wait so that they can... I know the world's been getting you, babe. Because you might be like, oh, this... Everyone might be telling you this is a toxic relationship in some way because of the devil here. You may also be feeling that way. It is such a heavy load, you got to hold on. See? And what's the other thing? Don't let your heart be confused no more. I feel this is, they are talking about themselves, that don't be confused, don't be misled. I'm almost there, baby. They are trying to say that, yeah, they are trying to heal this confusion and they are trying to work and not getting misled in this confusion of lovers and devil. They want to come back to you and they want to put all this heavy energies down and come to you with a promise of love. It's a beautiful, powerful reading. Thank you so much. Please subscribe if you enjoyed this reading. Subscribe, friends. And if you want to, let me know in the comment section below if you enjoyed this reading. If you want to buy a personal reading, check the description box, friend. Check the description box. And Join us on Instagram and Facebook as Magic Wednesday. Tarot, this is Mystic C saying bye bye.